Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope everybody is doing good. Today we are going to discuss about steps in research methodology or steps of research. Okay, it's similar to process of research, but we are going to study in depth what are the steps we are going to follow while doing the research. It is helpful for the project, your students' project report, as well as the if you are doing a scholar thesis. Okay. So let us understand what are the steps which are going to be there in conducting research. I'm Balabi, Assistant Professor of Management with you to discuss about these steps in research methods. Okay. Or we can say it is as a research process. Let us start. So we know that all the researchers research having a common goal for what we have to understand as a problem, and we know that we can problem first we understand the problem, then we navigate this problem to come to a conclusion or to make a decision about certain uneasiness which is there in the while conducting the research. That is a problem we have to understand, and we have to further do the research to come to a conclusion or come to a decision or come to a findings, right? So this is a research steps or a sequence which are going to be there, which are going to be conducted by any researcher while doing the research. Okay, then we have eight stages in research processes. That are, first one is identifying problem, reviewing the literature, setting the research questions, objectives and hypothesis, choosing the research design or study design, deciding about the sampling design, collecting the data, processing and analyzing the data, and writing the report. We have studied similar thing in research process also. Again, we are going to discuss in a different manner in this class. Okay, first one is identifying the problem, that will lead to literature reviews, and that will lead the literature. After reviewing the literature, it will lead to formulating your objective hypothesis and the research question. After formulating hypothesis and research question, you will decide about the, for to test my hypothesis, my research hypothesis, what kind of design it should be there, whether it is a descriptive research or a experimental research, or it could be a causal research, or it could be a exploratory research. After that, we have to select the sampling design. Okay, whether it may have to go for probability sampling or non-probability sampling. Then I have to collect the data from the decided sample. Okay, after collecting the data, we have to analyze the data in understandable manner and interpret the data, right? Then after interpreting the data, we have to write all the steps what we have undergone, and we have to make it as a report, right? To present that report or make use that report as an evidence for future research purposes, as well as for to get award of a MBA, BBA, or BCom or MCom or your doctoral PhD, right? So first stage, let us start with identifying the problem. Identifying the problem here means problem should not be, it must not be a problem or like decline of sales or decline of increase of turnover or something like that. Problem is something which we are want to study, or if you want to come to a conclusion, or you want to take a decision upon. Okay, so here the important question is whether all problems in pertaining in an organization are researchable problems. Okay, whether all the problems have to be addressed through research, or management have an intuition to solve those problems, right? Researchable problem is different from non-researchable problems. Okay, so we have to understand the difference between researchable problem and non-researchable problem. Some problems which can be identified and answered by management itself by the intuition or a previous experience, that is a non-researchable problem. Researchable problem requires investigation, requires the collection of data, requires the analysis, that is called as researchable problem. So that to keeping that whether the all the things which management want to take decision upon, either it is a researchable problem or non-researchable problem, we have to identify it, and further we have to go for the formulating the problem, right? So once we have chosen that, yes, it is a research, we've decided that, yes, we want to do research only. We cannot go through the intuition or we cannot take decision upon, then we have to do the research upon. How to, then it can be, formulated as research broadly available problem could be converted into a narrowly researchable problem. Okay. So this, the steps which are required to follow before decision is taken to whether it is going to be a researchable study or non-researchable study, that is three steps. So first we have to state the problem, then we have to justify that statement, then we have to analyze the problem. If you go through these stages, then only we can say that our problem is formulated or research problem is formulated. So first one is statement of the problem. It is a clear, well-defined statement, like it is in quote, like a study on consumer behavior towards XYZ product. That is your well-defined statement of research, research problem. Then we have to justify the problem by asking the question why the problem is study is important, why we have to understand the consumer behavior of XYZ product, because it is a new product or because it is a new addition to the existing product. So like that, why the problem is important. So we have to understand whether our customers will accept our new feature of the product or not. We have to identify these things, right? We have to justify why it is the important to study about this statement, right? Next one is analyze the problem. So where we have to give the critical attention, we have to critically evaluate, like whether managers or users and researcher can take decision upon or not, the problem could be achievable problem or not, or problem where we can do research or not. We have to understand by critically evaluating the our problem, right? Next one is second step in research steps are reviewing the literature. So reviewing the literature says that it can be a review of the existing literature which is already available, which has already conducted research, has been conducted on a similar topic, or the your to understand the concepts of theories or models, you can go to the conceptual research literature review. So why we have to do the literature review is to we have to see that whether I am repeating my research, whether I am repeating or duplicating my research, okay? And it helps us to learn about the more about research problem, like how we have understood exploring more about by exploratory, in exploratory research, we explore more by understanding the secondary and primary literature review, right? So that's why we have to understand whether, to understand more about my problem, we have to go to the literature review of literature. Then it helps our familiar with the types of methodology for particular topic, what the previous researcher have used those methodology, whether it is applicable to my topic or not, or you can identify that we can use another methodology to identify my topic, another methodology to prove or to get extra something which is not done before in the previous research of the similar problem, okay? So again, literature review will help and understand the concepts and theories of the particular thing. If I'm talking about consumer behavior, new product launch, then we have to understand the concepts and theories of like definition, features, characteristics, different models developed by different philosophers. We have to understand the concept first, then only we can go for the research. Then it is understand, is there any controversies are available if you are doing a certain research, maybe some kind of environmental issues it might be, or animal harmfulness, or some or any plagiarism kind of or patents, some kind of controversies are available, or any findings which we have opted in the previous researches or which are inconsistent. If I also conduct the same research, my findings could also be inconsistent. We have to understand that literature review is important. Okay, and this the literature review will help us to understand the unanswered research questions, the questions which cannot be answered through intuition or management decision. After doing thorough research literature review of literature, we will understand the certain research questions. Okay, then it will give us a framework. What we can, how we can do conduct our research to understand the framework. Also, literature review will help us, and it will understand what are the variables which can be studied in the existing problem. Then setting research question, objectives and hypothesis. So what is objective? Objective will tell us the what I want to study, right? What I want to study. So that's why it is an information that should be collected, and it provide the framework for the, and it provide the scope of the study, and its objective is you should formulate, and we have to, that will help us in testing the hypothesis. Okay, objective is something which we want to understand. What is the our intention of doing our research? What problem or what variables or what is the that area or what is the study which we are going to conduct as a research? So this objective will give us a aim to do the research. Okay, then we have to formulate the hypothesis. Hypothesis are nothing but the assumptions, okay, or possible solutions which you are guessing before starting of the research, right? So we have to formulate the hypothesis. After formulating hypothesis, next step will come as choosing the study design. So we have to choose the research design related to which are applicable to my research. Okay, so according to the nature and characteristic of the research, after reviewing the literature, we'll find out the gap, then we'll find out the objective, what we have to study, and we'll come to assumption that this could be my result for my objectives. After doing this, I have to decide whether my research is a type of descriptive research, or I can go with the exploratory research, or I can go with the observation or a census or experimental research. So we have to decide about the what kind of research design we are going to talk about. Okay, so it can be a survey, experiment, or only secondary data study, or only observational study. It depends upon the nature of the problem which is pertaining to study. We have to decide about the research design. Okay, so research design to be chosen from among the four design depends primarily on four factors. What is that? What I was telling you right now, that is what is the type of problem which I have. Okay, where I want to make a relationship between variables, I cannot go for exploratory research, right? I have to go for the descriptive research or experimental research. Okay, what are the objectives under study? If I want to know the effect of online advertisement on purchasing of buying behavior of consumer, I have to go for, that is my objective, then I have to go for descriptive kind of research, not the exploratory kind of research. If I want to know the purchase, why the people are purchasing my product, that can be a exploratory research. Okay, then existing knowledge about problem that is being studied, what is already we have with us by doing literature review. Depending upon that, we have to decide that what kind of research design I have to choose for my research, right? Then the resources available for the study, whether it is online resources, published resources, printed resources, whether it is the previous thesis or a research paper or a books or textbook or journal articles. You have to decide about the what are the available resources I have. It includes your time, your cost, and as well as the your efforts. Okay, what are the resources I have to study to take up this research? Depending upon which, you have to decide about the research design. Okay, next step after deciding research design, then you decide about the what is sampling method I have to go through and what is the data collection method I have to go through. Again, this will depend upon your characteristics of your problem. and what are the objective of your problem, depending upon which I have to select the sample, right? Sampling design refers to in the from the universe, you have to select the population. In this population, you have to make your sampling frame. From the sampling frame, you have to select your sample. So this one person is your sample unit. Okay, this is your sample, total sample size for the this is sampling frame. This is population. This is your universe. So this is how you have to decide whether I have to, how to choose this sample unit or the sample size from our given universe, right? Whether you want to go for the probability sampling technique or non-probability sampling technique, that depends again upon your nature of the study, okay? If you want to study the number of visitors in a shopping mall, you go for probability sampling, that you can randomly choose anybody. If you want to select that, if you want to study that effect of, effect of watching mobile phones too much on the, health of eyes, then you have to choose the, you cannot choose randomly. Then you have to get the expert kind of project, samples there. That's why you can go for non-probability sampling. That is a convenient judgmental sampling or a convenient sampling you can choose. Like that, we have to choose the, decide this, our sampling design. After that, once your sample is, sample size is ready, you have decided that I'm going to collect the sample in definite matter, then you will do the, data collection, right? So collecting the data collection. This data collection can be done through data collection tool, which is called, we call it as a questionnaire. It is not necessarily necessary for every research to have a questionnaire, right? If it is more about a secondary oriented research, the questionnaire is not applicable. If you're doing a primary kind of data collection, then you have to have the questionnaire. Okay, or Google form, or through emails or telephone interview, structured interview, depth interview, focus group discussion. These are the type of various methods of collecting the data. Collecting the data is nothing but your sample is there. From that sample, you're going to collect the opinion, feelings, or the behavior, or the frequency of how, if you're collecting data about, whether they are liking to buy your product or not, then it is the sample which you have selected, then you have to collect the data from this sample, whether they like or do not like to buy your product, right? So that is called as a data collection. You're collecting first-hand information. You're collecting first-hand information from the your sample size, that is called as primary data collection. If you're collecting the data which is already available from the previous studies or secondary sources, it is a second-hand data collection, right? So you can use both the methods to collect the data. Next one is, after collecting the data, you have a bundle of questionnaires. Take an example of primary data collection, you have a bundle of questionnaires. Or secondary data collection, you have a bundle of financial statement available, you have downloaded from your respective company websites, you have annual reports. That is, you cannot come to a conclusion or take a decision upon by merely looking up the financial reports. If you want to come to a conclusion or take a decision upon, we have to analyze the data. If you want to know the performance of the company for previous 5 years, then you have to go to their balance sheet, look for assets side, look for liability side, go to the P&L account, look for the profit and loss, sales, compare the sales from 1 year to second year to fifth year to third year. So you do, you analyze the data like this, then and interpret that why the difference is there in the sales or profit from the past 5 years, why it has happened. You select some statistical tools to or techniques or methods to analyze your data. You can use the tabulation, frequency analysis, or multivariate analysis. You apply all those things to your collected data. You convert your opinion, feelings, and attitude, likes. These kind of data, if you collected, then you convert them into a numerical data so that you can apply statistical and mathematical tool to understand the or come to a conclusion or to take decision upon, you have to convert them into numbers. Then after converting to numbers, you have to apply mathematical or statistical tool to understand or interpret the data. Okay. After this step, after you have done everything, you have selected the problem, you have justified the problem, analyzed the problem, then you have reviewed the literature related to your problem, then you have understood exactly or you have thorough knowledge about problem after review of literature, then you have done the your objective, you have formulated objective, you have formulated hypothesis, then you have selected the research design which is applicable depending upon the characteristics and the objectives of the problem, then you have collected the data, then you have analyzed the data. Now everything is done, the conclusion is arrived, and you have got findings, and you have to put it in a report format to present it, right? So for that, it is like your dissertation or thesis or a project report you call. So that is the writing report. You have to write report. So first you have to get the outline, then we have to write the research report. Usually the research report follows a general report would be follow these kind of steps. First you have to give executive summary, a short form of whatever your research is. It's about 1 and 1.5 pages. Then what is the background of problem, why this problem has to be studied, why this problem you are undertaking to study. Then related literature review, you have to give in your understanding that what has happened in the previous studies and what is not happened, that why you want to do this research, right? Then the methodology, what is the sampling technique, what is the data collection tool, what is the data collection technique, what kind of research you are doing, that is research methodology. Then findings, discussion and conclusion, you will get it out after analyzing and interpreting data, and you have to give the recommendation for the further researchers. Okay, this is about the steps in research process or steps of research. You can say that there are 8 steps. First, we identify the problem. What is the problem? Whether it is a researchable problem or it is just a management can intuitionally take decide upon the problem, or it is actual a research problem. You have to identify it. And after identifying, you put it in a statement format. Then you justify the problem. Then you analyze the problem and make it a researchable, ready to research problem. Then you have to review the literature related to your problem, or you understand the concepts and theories of which is related to your research problem. Then comes to the you have to find out the questions, research questions, why, what, when, and based upon which you have to formulate the objectives. Objectives are nothing but why you have to do aim of the your research project. Then you formulate the assumption or hypothesis or suggested results of your research to prove or disprove. We have to, after doing this, we have to come to a conclusion that which type of research design is applicable to my problem and to my research problem's objective. Then after deciding the research design, sampling technique and sampling tools and data collection technique and tools, you decide about the sample design, whether you're going to be probability or non-probability sampling. Then collect the data primary or secondary by using primary or secondary methods. Then after collecting the data, you analyze the data, put it in statistical format, test them for the hypothesis, prove or disprove your hypothesis. Then you come to you come to findings, your suggestions and your conclusions. You write all these things, whatever you have done in your research report. Okay, so this is about the steps of research. I hope you all understood the steps of research. It is similar to research processes. I have made both the videos. You can go through with the research process also, steps of research process also, one another the same. I've given 2 times explanation with using different examples, which will help you in getting more understanding about the process or steps of research. Thank you.